Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for Current Affairs. I welcome you all in this video, and the questions that I'm going to discuss in this video can be of use for you if you are appearing for RBI Sevin Award or any kind of banking examination at the level of PU. So let's begin today's video, but before that, if you're a newcomer, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with free quizzes, as well as you can directly connect with your mentors on this group. This is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022, and in this course, you will get PDFs, videos and mocks along with the interview preparation. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your interviews as well. This is the booklet that you will get, and in this booklet, all these books will be delivered at your doorstep. Right now, we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you want to avail that discount, you can use RBI30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can dial if you have any kind of queries related to the course or eligibility of the exam or anything related to the examination. You can just call us on this number to get it resolved. So that was all. Now let's begin with the first question. When was One Stop Center's Sakhi scheme launched? So basically, this Sakhi scheme is the scheme of Ministry of Women and Child Development. Now, what is the purpose of this Sakhi scheme and what is the reason for which it is in the news, that we will discuss a little later. But first, let's discuss when was the scheme launched. So it was launched in the year 2015. Now, recently, the Ministry of Women and Child Development has announced that it is going to open 10 such one-stop centers in 9 different countries in partnership with Ministry of External Affairs. Now, what is the purpose of these one-stop centers? So basically, the basic purpose of this Sakhi centers is to provide help to the women who are suffering violence in different countries, in foreign countries, basically. So Sakhi is friend in English. So these centers will help the women who are suffering violence at the hands of foreigners or at the hands of their own family members in the foreign land can get help from these centers. And remember that 10 one-stop centers are going to be established by Ministry of Child, Women and Child Development with Ministry of External Affairs. So that was all about the news for which this Sakhi scheme was in the news. Okay, so that was all about this first question. Now you have to mention the ministers of both the ministries, Ministry of Women and Child Development as well as External Affairs. Okay, so the next question is, where is India's first city-based environmental surveillance platform for COVID, named as Precision Health Platform, launched? So Ajmer, Agra, Bangalore, Guwahati and Imphal are in the options. Out of these, Bangalore is the right answer. So in Bangalore, India's first city-wide environmental surveillance platform for COVID has been launched. So the first thing here that you should remember is that the name of this platform is Precision Health Platform. So that is the very first and crude fact related to this news. Now, second thing here is the understanding why this platform has been launched or what is its function. So the basic function of launching this environmental surveillance platform is to surveil the sewage or to test the sewage water and to detect the coronavirus in that water, so that the coronavirus can be tracked at an early stage and mitigative actions can be taken so that COVID-19 spread can be curtailed in the city of Bangalore. Okay. So this platform has been launched in partnership with USAID and COVID Action Collab. So these are the two agencies that are partnering with the Karnataka government so that this first ever citywide environmental surveillance platform can be launched. So guys, remember that it is India's first such platform that has been launched, and the purpose is to detect the virus of corona in the sewage water so that mitigative actions can be taken so that we can curtail the spread of coronavirus pandemic. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. NASA is planning to send its first mobile robot named Volatile investigating polar exploration rover to which planet? So we have Solar, Lunar, Jupiter, Neptune, Venus. So Lunar is not a planet, actually it is a satellite, but still it is in the option and it is the right answer. So Lunar, that is this Viper, is the rover that is going to be sent to the moon. Now, what is the purpose of sending Viper to the moon? The basic purpose is to do research on the resources found on the moon. Now, guys, remember that it is going to be launched by the year 2023. Okay. And it is a part of the Artemis mission of NASA. Now, what is this Artemis mission? You must have heard about this mission many times. Now, Artemis mission is the mission of NASA that aims to send first women and first man of color to the moon. So that is why this Artemis mission is important. Your question is to tell me the timeline of this mission. When is this mission going to be launched by NASA? Now, remember that this Viper will be launched before Artemis, and therefore the Artemis mission is going to follow the wheel print of Viper towards the moon's south pole. So remember that Chandrayaan 2 also attempted to reach the south pole of the moon that has not been trodden by any other country. Now, this is going to be the first time, if NASA becomes successful, that USA will become the first country to reach south pole of the moon. So that is something that only time can tell us. But for the time being, you should remember that Viper is going to be sent to the moon, and the basic purpose is the exploration of minerals on lunar surface. Okay, so that was all about this question. I hope that it is clear to you now. And remember the full form of Viper as well, because it can also be asked in the examination. So that was all for this question. Do not forget to answer my question in the comment section below. So the next question is, who has won the 13th International ENI Awards 2020 from India? So first of all, you should know two things about this award. First thing is that this award is considered as the Nobel Prize in the field of renewable energy. So here you can yourself assess the importance of this award. The second thing is that it is given by a company of Italy, and that company is named as ENI. So this ENI is the name of the Italian company that sponsors this international ENI award. And remember, it is given in the field of renewable energy, considered as the Nobel of renewable energy. Okay. Now coming back to the question that who has won this award from India. So we have the five options. Out of these five options, the right answer is option A, C and R Rao. Now remember guys, this award has also been given in different categories to different people, but since the list of winners is huge and I don't think that a question can come up in your RDS webinar bar regarding the other winners, therefore I have left it out, but the important winner from India is mentioned right here. So I would like you guys to restrict your scope of this news to this much information only. Okay, otherwise it will just blow your mind away. The next question is, who has won International Dublin Literary Award 2021 for Lost Children Archive novel? So here the novel has been given to you guys. You should remember that this International Dublin Literary Award 2021 has been given to this novel or the author of this novel. So it is one and the same thing. Okay. Now who has won this? It is option A, Valeria Lucero, and she is an author from Mexico. So remember that as well. Now guys, this International Dublin Literary Award is considered as the wealthiest award in the field of literature, and remember that it is given by the Dublin City Council of Ireland. So Dublin is the capital of Ireland. From here you can remember which country gives this award, or basically this Dublin City Council is the Council of Ireland that sponsors this International Dublin Literary Award. So that was all, but as I told you that it is the wealthiest award in the field of literature. So guys, can you find out that how much prize money is given to the winners? So consider this as your co-curricular activity and tell me in the comment section below how much is the amount of this prize. So that was all for today. I hope that you have enjoyed it. And if you have, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can just like this video and share it among your friends if you have really liked the content. Thank you so much for watching the video.